love jokes. Every year on his birthday, he would have jokes. So over the years, he would develop symptoms such as vomiting, headaches, and nausea. And one year, he had some jokes. He became paralyzed and had to go to the hospital. The doctor said the disease he had was further jokes poisoning, and it was already too late. And all his dad wanted to know was, why did Daddy love jokes? And he said, and then he died. Now you might want to know, what is paralytic shellfish poisoning, also known as PSP? Paralytic shellfish poisoning is a marine toxin that affects the nervous system, paralyzes your muscular system, but is not life-threatening. It's a short-term disease that's mainly caused in seafood such as shellfish, mussels, and scallops, since they are filter feeders where all the toxins can be absorbed. Some symptoms of paralytic shellfish poisoning include headaches, dizziness, nausea, vomiting, rapid pain, and anuria. Since this disease is so unusual, doctors put certain symptoms together to diagnose which type of poisoning they have, but there are many different types of shellfish poisoning, human and skin. There is a different group of paralytic shellfish poisoning. The first one, amnestic shellfish poisoning, also known as ASP, includes permanent short-term memory loss, brain damage, and death. The second one is diarrheal shellfish poisoning, also known as DSP, which includes diarrhea, nausea, and vomiting. The neurotoxic shellfish poisoning, also known as NSP, includes slurred speech, nausea, and vomiting. And last but not least, paralytic shellfish poisoning, includes PSP, but paresthesia, coordination loss, speech defects, nausea, vomiting, and death. Amnesic and paralytic shellfish poisoning are the most dangerous types because in many rare cases, they may lead to death. Treatments. Currently, there are no treatments for paralytic shellfish poisoning. Doctors may stop some of the symptoms, such as vomiting. But doctors can use a stomach pump to remove shellfish only if the patient has been treated within 3 hours of getting the disease. Symptoms such as vomiting dehydrate the patients, so doctors may give four pills to cope with dehydration. Here are some preventions for paralytic shellfish poisoning. A clue to know if you're eating contaminated shellfish poisoning if it is associated with red tide. The red tide is when plankton in the water reproduces in a large amount very quickly, and there are a lot of organisms in the water which turns the water into a red tide color. Many doctors suggest that it's best to eat cooked shellfish rather than raw because if it is cooked, it will have a lower chance of being contaminated with toxins such as PSP. Now, we will talk about the origin of paralytic shellfish poisoning. Paralytic shellfish poisoning was discovered 200 years ago, and was found on the Pacific coast during the voyage by Captain George Vancouver. During his exploration of Puget Sound in Washington State, Vancouver reported four of his men sick after eating mussels for breakfast. Only one crew member died, and this was the first case of paralytic shellfish poisoning. My experiment. An experiment was conducted on May 4, 2003 by scientists Serge Brugger, Patrick Pasous, Michelle Bardulli, Pierre Messelin, and Philip Chouquet. This experiment was about toxin absorbance in shellfish. Pacific oysters and king scallops were placed into different bones and were fed toxins for 2 weeks. The absorbance level was measured 2 times a day to see how much toxin could be absorbed by either the scallop or the shellfish. The data compared the real tissue toxin to the theoretical toxin and the accumulation rate. The result of the experiment showed high toxin rates for Pacific oysters and king scallops. The methods of this experiment was conducted on king scallops and Pacific oysters. From best grade fishermen, this area was not known for toxins such as paralytic shellfish poison or any of the other shellfish poisoning listed. Before this experiment, in order organisms were places to salt water for 5 to 6 days to make it ready for the experiment. The experiment was conducted to see how the absorbance level could be changed to either lower or higher the amount of absorbance rate that the parallel shellfish poisoning could go into the scallops for the shellfish. This experiment consisted of 35 oysters and 15 scallops. The control of this experiment was the shell. Organisms were fed 9 to 14 days, and the experiment was conducted 5 different times. The results. During the 5 experiments, the result of toxin concentration was noted to compare the oysters to the scallops to see which absorbs more toxin. The evidence shows if the animal absorbed more than 8 microliters of PSP, it was positive for shellfish poisoning. In this experiment, more oysters were contaminated with parallel shellfish poisoning and scallops. In conclusion, PSP is not a deadly disease. Someone can only die in rare cases if either too much is taken in or their symptoms are stronger than normal. This disease is a short-term disease, which means it will only last once all the shellfish is digested and is out of your system. Currently, there is no cure for PSP. Most symptoms will go away after the poisoning is completely digested. Thank you. And remember, check the shell before you wreck yourself.
So you can check your shell. You would get the beginning of PSP, so like you have a team that comes.
Walter, could you repeat that louder? Sorry.
So you have a chance of getting a PSP even when the shellfish are in the stuff.
You do, but in most cases, it is like the shellfish. Most of the shellfish are not contaminated, but the ones that are, you still have a chance of getting it even if it is.
What did it mean by the control with the shell?
Like they change how much the control is, like what you can change in the experiment to see which, how you can like change the result. And the result was how much toxin were absorbed. And the, what I think about the control is the shell was changed different times to see how, if you can get a higher rate of death in the shell or a lower toxin absorbance rate with the different shell. Does that answer your question?
I'm still a little confused about that.
Okay, you get one shell, okay, and they change the shell level on each, on a different shellfish that scallop to see if that, if like, if the shell depends, like, if the shell, if the shell can change how much toxin the animal absorbs.
So toxins cause shellfish to get disease. So like the Gulf of Mexico spill happened, those types of toxins count.
Well, currently the only toxins were, since shellfish and scallops are filter feeders, they get it from they get it from other algae that carry toxins.
Yes. how you know that what you're eating and the shellfish in your intestine has.
You would know because usually the restaurants, they would say, it would have a caution, it would say red tide.
What is the mortality rate of this disease here?
That is a good question. Apparently, I haven't found out because the disease is so rare. There's not many cases of death, only just symptoms.
Thank you.
All right, one more question.
Out of all the people that eat shellfish, what is the percent of the people that will get the disease?
There's probably, there'll be like, from my knowledge on the disease, there'll probably be one out of 100.
One out of what?
100.
Okay.
All right, Jeff and